fall in love with snakes actually starting my university life, when I learned how misunderstood they are, how people are put off by how supposedly scary they are. And as I learned, I grew more fond of them. The four reasons I think why people are afraid of snakes. Number one, maybe because they are limbless, they don't have arms or legs. And another possible reason that I get quite often is that maybe because snakes always bite people. But statistically speaking, the chances is actually very, very low. It's only like one in every 500,000 people will die from a snake bite. Another common answer that I always get would be, we are born that way. Humans are born to be afraid of snakes. My personal favorite answer, we learn to fear snake. You can still remember, like when you're younger, whenever you go into a forest to run around, maybe your parents will tell you, oh, if you run around in the forest, a snake will bite you. Usually when people ask you how to differentiate a venomous snake from a non-venomous one, the most common answer would be the triangle head, right? Or maybe the color. This colorful one is a venomous snake, right? There's even one that says that, oh, look under the tail. If the scales is in pairs, it means it's a venomous snake. Triangle head usually refers to pit vipers, right? So pit vipers are venomous. But there are also snakes like the cat snake, like maybe the vine snake. They also have somewhat of a triangle head, but they are not dangerous to human. So just judging by the head shape is definitely not the way to go. Judging by the color, there's always some non-venomous one mimicking venomous one. So color is also not a good way to call whether it's a venomous or non-venomous snake. And about the scale underneath the tail, definitely you won't go and check the tail whenever you encounter a snake, right? There's actually a book published by MyBiz. It's titled Land Snake of Medical Significance in Malaysia. So that book, you can go ahead and read through it. There's a lot of pictures in it that will help you identify the venomous species. If you encounter a snake in the wild, so what you should do is definitely don't engage it. The snake is not dangerous unless you put yourself there in its way. But if you encounter them at home, keep an eye on them, make sure you know where they are. Call our civil defense or call the Bomba to come and help you relocate them. The major threats to our snakes is definitely habitat loss. That's where you see extinction, or you see more of these human and snake encounters because they are forced out of their natural habitat. Another thing which is quite serious in Southeast Asia, which is the illegal pet trade. People go into forests, catch these snakes to sell them or keep them as pets for personal gain. Another thing would be traditional Chinese medicine. People always believe like, oh, these venomous snakes probably have a very good medicinal value to it. So they soak them in alcohol, they cook it, they eat it. Fact is, there's no actually scientific evidence to prove that. And all these are just threatening our snake species. Lastly, it would be climate change. All these species that are endemic to highland area, to the cooler environment, are facing this threat because temperature is very different for them. They are losing their habitat, how much range they can go to. So those things are also going extinct. What people can do to help with perhaps snakes conservation, first of all, learn more about them, read up about them, communicate your knowledge. You can share it with your friends, family, so everyone have the right idea on what is our snakes like over here in Malaysia. Another very important thing that you should do is talk about snake in a more neutral or at least a more positive way. Additionally, you can also change fear to respect. You don't have to fear about snake, you just have to respect them. Give them their space, give them their distance. Same goes to other animals as well. There's nothing in the wild that you should be afraid of. You just have to respect them, give them the proper space that they need.